This evening, the big question is Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiya correct when he says he owes no answers to either the citizens or the media? Or should he be answering questions on what is going on in the Bengaluru jail? Are allegations of a 2 crore bribe for Sasikala's comforts actually true? And why was DIG D. Rupa shunted out? Joining me this evening, GVL Narasimha Rao, National Spokesperson of the BJP, Danish Ali, General Secretary of the JDS, Bijon Mishra, Consumer Right Activist, T.K. Silangovan, MP and Chief Spokesperson of the DMK, Alimuddin Khan, political analyst, Sanjay Hegde, senior advocate, joining me live from Delhi, and CM Dhananjay, chairman, Karnataka Pradesh Congress Committee, legal cell. CM Dhananjay, it's an absolute arrogant response from the chief minister when he says he owes nobody any answers. Of course, as a public servant. Okay, we will go across to CM Dhananjay in just a bit. But first, let me go across to Danish Ali. Danish Ali, is this the way the Bengaluru jail is run? And does Mr. Siddaramaiya owe any answers to the public when he shifts an officer who's an honest officer, who's been the whistleblower in this case, and she raises these questions, sends 2 reports, and he shuns her out within 26 days of her being appointed? If any officer in the police service is shunted out before 2 years of his tenure, isn't the chief minister supposed to give an explanation in writing why he is shifting such an officer?
Not at all, Navika. This type of brazen transfer and upright officers being punished cannot be tolerated at all. But this is not the only case of Karnataka. We do remember how Sangeeta Kalia was humiliated by BJP minister in Haryana, Anil Viz. How the BJP MLA made the young IPS officer crying on the streets while she was implementing the law and order in the Gorakhpur, in Yogi Adityanath's state. We remember how Shrestha Thakur, the DSP of Bulandshahr, was humiliated, threatened by BJP workers, and she was told that you will be removed, and she was removed. She was punished because she did not toe the line of the BJP workers in Bulandshahr. She was posted just few months back. So this is not the single case. Our any upright officer anywhere in any state want to clean up the system, they are being targeted. So nobody can accept this. It's not the isolated case of Karnataka. There are many cases in BJP ruled states also, other parties ruled state also. But as far as this thing is concerned, let the inquiry takes place. And if DIG...
But how can even before the inquiry, Mr. Danish Ali, even before the inquiry has begun, how can the chief minister shunt out somebody? How can the chief minister shunt out the whistleblower even before the inquiry has taken place?
I think the DIG prison should also be removed from there, and independent inquiry should take place. I am not here defending Siddaramaiah's government or his action. I am with any upright officer anywhere in the country, whether it's D. Rupa or Sangeeta Kalia or Shrestha Thakur or Charu Nigam of Gorakhpur. Any upright officer, particularly the female police officer, should be bagged. Not like this, what has happened.
Oh, you're making this a gender issue. Let me go across to Alimuddin Khan. Alimuddin Khan, isn't it the height of arrogance by the chief minister of Karnataka when he says that he is not answerable to the media on why he's transferring an officer who in this case is a whistleblower, who's written 2 reports, she's made serious allegations of a 2 crore bribe being paid to give comforts to Sasikala in the Bengaluru jail. These are not simple charges. These are very, very serious charges. And even before the inquiry can actually take off, she's shunted out. What kind of administration and governance is this? Is every honest officer supposed to be victimized? Is that what Mr. Siddaramaiah says?
Navika ji, director general of police called police review meeting. He took time from the chief minister on 10th July. And all DIG rank officers were invited to attend that meeting. Rupa ji, instead of attending chief minister's review and DGP police review meeting, she opted to go to jail and took some photograph from here and there and posted on the Facebook.
Number she was one. Doing her Number job.
Two. When she received...
She no, was she doing her job, Mr. Ali Mudin Khan. What objection do you have to an officer doing his job? And you are talking about a meeting that she did not attend before she wrote this report, sir.
Navika ji, let me reply, please. On 12th, she submitted report to DG, Mr. Rao Satyanarayana Rao, that these are the irregularities without any disclosure, without any basis, without any proof. She submitted the report to the DG. So now what government can do? Government has appointed Mr. Vinay Kumar, who was a Home Secretary in GOI, an outstanding officer, to inquire into this case. And DG has been removed from the post, and he has kept waiting for the posting. Compulsory waiting for the posting, number one. Number two, the discretion of the jail facilities depend on the superintendent of the jail. So jail superintendent, action against jail superintendent also has been taken already. Now, where is the case?
This, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao, Ali Mudin Khan's entire explanation
that's why she has been
actually alludes
by the
to the portion of behavior before the report was given by DIG D. Rupa, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao. It was only before the report was given that she did not attend a meeting, and that's being made into a reason why she's not a good officer. I ask you a simple question. If an honest, upright officer has written not one
not
but two reports and actually pointed out...
Chief Minister's meeting, police meeting...
Ali Mudin Khanji, allow me to...
Not attending Chief Minister... Navika ji, not attending.
It's not a bigger crime than it's not a bigger crime than pointing out the 2 crore rupee bribe, sir. What about the 2 crore bribe, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao? Is the Congress deflecting attention away? Are they pointing to?
Navika, can I?
Are they pointing to omissions? Are they pointing to omissions of D. Rupa, the DIG, only because they want to actually put a lid on the fact that 2 crore rupee bribes were given for Sasikala to get these kind of amenities? And those visuals on your screen, ladies and gentlemen, continuously look at them.
That is
polished floors,
allegation.
5-room suite given. That's not a baseless. Those are
Navika,
those are visuals, sir, and pictures don't lie. Pictures actually speak the truth. Those are the pictures.
Navika,
look
ji,
at
where,
the clothes
where,
that
where
she's been
report?
Given. Other prisoners are given 2 saris and 2 blouses,
and
1 plate, one bowl, and 1 tumbler. Look at the utensils.
You saw the disclosure report.
Photographs are also fabricated. Why does Congress think that everything that does not suit them is actually fabricated, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao? Why does everything that does not suit the Congress party actually be something that has been fabricated?
Navika, I think let's look at the gravity of the charges that have been made in the report. Let us keep everything aside. The charges are verifiable. That Telgi is enjoying star comforts in the jail does not require more than 10 minutes to go and verify. The fact that Sasikala was being given comforts which were not due to her can be verified in 30 minutes. So the charges itself about the 2 crore bribe, possibly some kind of corroborative evidence is required to establish that. But these are verifiable charges. They should have allowed, if Siddaramaiah was clean, if he did not have his hands in the till, he should have taken action against all these people right away. And he should have shown the people of Karnataka that he means business. But here you have a situation where the entire racket is being scripted and directed by Siddaramaiah himself as the chief minister and the home minister. Therefore, all the actions that he has taken are for a cover-up operation. He does not want this to get bigger. He does not want any other revelations in this manner. So by acting against Rupa, he has sent a signal to the entire bureaucracy and the police authorities that I will be vindictive. If you expose anything more, I am going to take action against you. So this is an operation that he is doing. This is a cover-up operation, not an administrative action. And Siddaramaiah and his government are directly complicit in this camp. So this is just one part of it. I think what Rupa has exposed in 20 days, submitting two reports, you go and examine all the jails in Karnataka, you might see this as a much, much wider and bigger scam than what it is. So what Siddaramaiah has done is to try and contain further damage. Therefore, a probe by an officer and something that will take a long time is not going to convince anybody. This probe is actually a cover-up operation. If he has the guts, he should allow the media to inspect these jails. Why does he not have the courage to open up these jails for media inspection? Why can he not do it? If he is transparent,
Mr. CM Dhananjay, answer that question. In fact, Mr. CM Dhananjay, the D. Rupa second report actually says that the kitchenware has been moved since she last examined it and did the recce of the jails. Also, she says that 32 people have been shifted out of the Bengaluru jail to Bellary and Belgaum. And these were the people who had spoken about the atrocities and the high-handedness of the SP Krishna Kumar. Yesterday, around 800 prisoners assembled in the ground. Grievances were aired to the DIG where no commotion was there. Why has D. Rupa been transferred, Mr. CM Dhananjay? And why should questions not be asked to Chief Minister, Mr. Siddaramaiah, who says he owes no answers? Is that the arrogance of the Congress party that you will not reply to any answers, any questions that have been raised by the citizens of this country, by the media? What kind of a chief minister is this who doesn't owe any accountability to any person, Aam Aadmi or the media?
See, first of all, I like to state that you cannot say like that what type of chief minister. One of the best chief minister you have seen, ever seen Karnataka, ever seen from the past 15 years. Point, I'm just coming to you. Point, this is a transfer, it's a routine job. Transfer because we got an 150 IPS officer, it is a common and routine for transferring for administrative reason and various reason. It is a common and it is in a convenience purposes. As far as other thing, allegation and counter allegation is concerned.
Yes, it is very convenient. Yes, Mr. CM Dhananjay, it is extremely convenient for you because she has pointed out to the taint, she has pointed out to the bribe giving. That's why it's convenient. If a police officer is shifted out before a 2-year tenure, then there have to be reasons that have to be given in writing for the transfer. What are the reasons that have been given, Mr. Dhananjay? Just because Ms. D. Rupa had been
in her position as DIG prison for 26 days. When there is an allegation and counter allegation, it is left to the department, DPR, it is the one which follows. For various administrative reason, they will transfer it. It is not that she is only transferred, there is many other people also transferred. And also there is an allegation and counter allegation. Immediately our chief minister ordered for the high level inquiry. So let the inquiry report come out. Till then, let us not argue the matter, because there is various department. There is 150 departments are there. There are certain issues he'll take up between the officers that will be looked into in accordance with law. There is a procedure. There is a manual. Jail manual is there. Prisoner rules is there. Service rules is there. All this will be looked
into. The jail manual has been violated.
Issue out of this.
Mr. Bejon Mishra.
In fact, the people of Karnataka. No, in fact, the people.
best job when you actually transfer a DIG within 26 days of her appointment just because she points to some wrongdoings? You are saying we should compliment the Chief Minister? Mr. Bijoy Mishra, don't you see this entire action reeks of vendetta? The Chief Minister seems to have made up his mind that the Bengaluru prison should run on bribe. And that is why he's shunted out D. Rupa. Isn't that very clear and apparent to anybody who's watching? Why has D. Rupa been removed within 26 days? Because she raised the point of a 2 crore bribe being given, and you've seen those visuals, Mr. Bijoy Mishra. 5-room suite, yoga mat, television, utensils, clothes, much in excess of any other prisoner, and a private room to meet her visitors. We don't know, there were no CCTV cameras working in that visitor's room. We don't know if people brought her cash, whether she took cash, whether she used that cash to actually buy herself comforts in the prison. Absolutely no record. Should the Chief Minister be answerable or not?
No, if there is any irregularity has taken place, you can always, there are the officers are there, they are going to place all the record before the committee. Let the committee is inquiring. When the inquiry is going on,
can you please
I don't
keep
like
quiet?
To question any of the question you are asking. If there is any people wanted to raise such thing, they can raise so before the committee. You can ask the committee to put up if you
can
got
you
anything you
quiet?
Also kindly give in writing and give it to the committee. Place before the committee.
You have spoken
when
enough.
The committee is formed.
You we have spoken enough.
It is
keep
now
quiet.
Custody control command of the
It's time for you to keep quiet.
When the committee is inquiring, is a prejudice in case we discuss about
it. It's time for you to keep quiet. You please keep quiet for 2 minutes.
No, you don't say, you don't have any right to say that.
Take
you
a
keep
rest.
Quiet. Why do you speak?
Take rest.
I am answering when she asks.
You take rest.
Keep quiet.
You take rest.
Until I speak,
you please
don't
take
have
rest.
To say that. Understand?
You please take rest. No, you are not
you
answering.
Keep quiet.
It's my
you
turn.
Don't have any
it's
right
my
to
turn.
You
are taking my time. It's
please,
my turn.
You
are taking away
I
my time.
When she asks
the anchor has addressed the question to me. Please
keep quiet. Yeah, I am not. You, I am.
Please keep quiet.
Question,
it's not your turn.
Ask me to stop it.
The anchor has answered.
Mr. CM Dhananjay, Mr. CM Dhananjay,
please keep quiet.
Mr. CM Dhananjay, that is the arrogance of the Congress Party, Mr. CM Dhananjay. That is the arrogance of the Congress Party. You don't want to hear the Aam Aadmi's voice. You want to speak over everybody. You don't want to be accountable. Listen to what citizens of this country have to say. And Mr. Bijoy Mishra is a respected citizen. Yes, Mr. Bijoy Mishra, go on.
No, all the citizens, all
you
the citizens of the state of Karnataka,
the
they
Karnataka Chief
the
Minister,
taken by the Honorable Chief Minister.
Again, he's speaking. Why don't you keep quiet for 2 minutes? Just keep quiet and listen.
It is a duty if anybody
wants to keep quiet and listen.
Our voice. Let
why are you talking?
Do so before the committee.
Why are you talking?
It is not.
Why are you talking? Why don't you keep quiet? Why don't you keep quiet?
Is there a citizen? So also we also citizen. There's a citizen in Karnataka state. He is not from the Karnataka. Kindly
keep quiet.
Question anything.
You are not a citizen.
What is going
you
on
are protecting
in Karnataka,
the culprits.
You, may not be knowing.
You are protecting criminals. You are protecting culprits.
You
are protecting
you
criminals.
Me.
You are not a citizen.
You
are anti-citizen.
You don't use such a word. Be careful.
You are anti-citizen. You are not protecting the citizens' rights. You are not protecting. You are protecting the criminals who are in the jail. Should be rotting. But you are giving them VVIP treatment. You are not fit to be a spokesperson of the Congress.
You
are a shame on the Congress of Karnataka.
You
are a shame. You are protecting something. You are ashamed to the Congress. We are ashamed of people like you who speak on behalf of the Congress and bring the Congress
to
a level which
is
very low. So don't speak now, please. Keep quiet. Keep quiet. Keep quiet. Keep quiet. Keep quiet. Listen to me.
Without knowing, don't talk. Without knowing the rules, regulation, don't talk. You keep quiet.
Mr. Dhananjay. Mr. Dhananjay.
Yes, because you don't speak. Yes, madam. He cannot Mr. Dhananjay, when I am answering please, to your question,
I know much more than you.
Anything, okay?
I know much more.
But Mr. Dhananjay, you are speaking non-stop. You are not allowing other panelists to speak, Mr. Dhananjay. I've given you your time. Mr. Dhananjay, I've given you your time.
If he is a respectable citizen, let him be a respectable citizen.
Okay, Mr. Dhananjay, I've given you your time.
He's a shame to the Congress.
Mr. Dhananjay.
To the Congress.
Mr. Dhananjay, I've given you your time. Now please listen to the others. Yes, Mr. Bijon Mishra.
Navika, it is a clear case of the Chief Minister institutionalizing corruption. You see, when the Chief Minister or the Karnataka government got exposed by a whistleblower within the government, it got to show to the citizens that at what level they can go and stoop down to take money to give favors. And it's all there in evidence. People don't have to prove that because it is there in evidence. You have captured them in a video and you're showing it to the citizens, number one. Number two, Congress does not have the right, or the Karnataka government does not have the right to transfer an honest officer. I think it is time the Karnataka citizens uprose and this protected such officers who are honest. And I would plead to Rupa that she should immediately put her papers. She should resign and the citizens will protect her. You know, like we did for Kiran Bedi, like we did for many police officers who were upright, who were honest. So I would like to put on record here, Rupa is a model for us. Rupa is a model for us. Let the Karnataka citizens now come onto the streets and protect Rupa to bring her back and reinduct her in that place from where she has been removed illegally. Because it has been done not as per the norms of transfer. It has been done because it's a vendetta. It is enough proof that this government is not pro-citizen. Please keep quiet.
That's what you think, Mr. Alimuddin Khan. That's what you think. But the citizens of this country know everything that's going on. Mr. Alimuddin Khan, you might think that people don't know. People know everything that's going on. Mr. Alimuddin Khan, don't defend the indefensible. Don't defend the indefensible.
What do you mean,
Sanjay Hegde? Before I go to Mr. TKS Ilangovan, let me get him a legal perspective on this. Sanjay Hegde, no, let other panelists speak before I come back to you, Mr. Alimuddin Khan. Sanjay Hegde hasn't spoken yet. Mr. Sanjay Hegde, isn't it very clear from the pictures that this kind of five-star treatment that is being given to Sasikala actually proves the fact that DIG Rupa, what she said in her report was correct? She's clearly pointed out to a 2 crore rupee bribe being paid. And that's evident from those visuals. A five-star, five-room suite. A different yoga room, a different bathroom, a different cooking room, a different sleeping room. Which prisoner gets these kind of amenities? And just look at the floor there, absolutely polished and shining. She meets her visitors in her room separately, no CCTVs there. What's going on? What are the kind of discussions that are going on? Nobody is inspecting that. Is that what a prisoner or a convict is supposed to get in a prison?
Okay, before I start, Navika, I just want to make a disclosure. I have appeared continually for the Karnataka government and I was responsible for the matter being transferred to Karnataka in one sense. So I will be measured in what I say. Then secondly, I've also appeared on the accused side in the Jayalalitha cases at a much later stage. Now, what you're basically showing is all these photographs. If you see those photographs, one thing struck me is that prison seems to have been built sometime in the 1960s and nothing seems to have changed very much. You have no doubt she may have been given 3-4 whatever rooms, but all that I could see was one kind of quilt, some mosquito net and a few utensils. Maybe that is very extraordinary for any prisoner in an Indian jail, but I think that is some kind of bare minimum. You must remember one thing. Karnataka has not sought custody of Sasikala. We were given that task by the Supreme Court, who transferred the trial. After the Supreme Court transferred the trial and the sentence also we have to execute, there are one or two things that you must bear in mind from the point of view of administration. First and foremost, if anything happens to the lady within the jail, we've had problems earlier between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. I don't want to elaborate on that. So if there are certain measures taken administratively to see that she is safe, that her privacy is relatively protected, I don't see something greatly wrong. The 2 crore figure is something else. Whoever has made the allegation, that person will prove it. No doubt that will come out in an inquiry. Right now, all that I can see is a room which does not seem to have changed very much since the days that Mr. L.K. Adwani occupied.
Mr. Bijon Mishra and all of us here, Mr. Sanjay Hegde, are extremely amused with your argument. Mr. Sanjay Hegde, you are talking of problems between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu if Sasikala is not looked after well. So, what should be done? A 2 crore bribe should be paid, amenities should be given, 5-room suites should be given, there should be lots of clothes for her, there should be mosquito nets for her, there should be a private cell where she meets. Where she meets her visitors in 31 days, 28 visitors, each meeting her for 45 minutes, Navika, without any CCTV recording, without any CCTV recording.
You render yourself and this channel liable for an action in defamation if somebody were to take it.
Mr. Sanjay Hegde, it is not enough in law. Let me just tell you the law. And your channel has suffered because of it. The DIG who raises Mr. Sanjay Hegde.
Navika Kumar, you please take responsibility for saying that 2 crores was paid. If you say so, then you will also be liable for defamation. That is the law. It is not enough to just report allegations. Please take responsibility.
Sanjay Hegde, Mr. Sanjay, that is the law. I'm just telling you the law. You want to go ahead and say, DIG Roopa, why has she been shunted within 26 days of her taking charge? When she's put out 2 reports alleging bribe giving, alleging irregularities, alleging VVIP treatment, why has she been transferred? Isn't that question number one? Question number two, why is she as a prisoner, the lone prisoner in Bengaluru jail who's been given a private room, a private cell with tables and chairs to meet her visitors? 28 visitors for her in 31 days in the month of February and March. 28 visitors without a CCTV recording. Is that normal behavior? Are you saying these are the bare minimum normal amenities that are available to other prisoners as well in the Bengaluru jail, Mr. Sanjay Hegde? Since you come from Karnataka, you would have seen these jails. Do other prisoners get the same kind of amenities?
You want to know that many of the people in politics have been in jail. You can please ask. Who has got what favors? I will tell you.
So people in politics should be treated differently, Mr. Bijon Mishra. People in politics, Sanjay Hegde, you either ask me a question or you interrupt.
You decide what you want to do. Now
Yes, GVL Narasimha Rao. Listen to this.
Mr. Bijon Bijon Mishra was arrested.
Shortly must understand the distinction between
masseur also gets arrested so that he gets his massage. No, Mr. Bijon Mishra is conveniently obfuscating issues. First and foremost, if anybody can come in, Navika, he's trying to mislead. Please move the Supreme Court and get an order taken away from Karnataka. That would be the best thing in the circumstances. The people of Karnataka have suffered long enough with that case being put on them and having had to conduct the trial, having had to face a lot of rioting.
Every time, just because a trial is conducted in Karnataka, you are justifying the treatment that's given to Sasikala, giving justification of Sasikala getting good treatment just because the trial was shifted out of Karnataka. I really don't understand the logic. Yes, GVL Narasimha Rao, I need to get this to TKS Langobarn, but before I go across to him, GVL Narasimha
Rao. You have to keep the lady safe.
No, please tell Mr. Hegde to remain quiet.
Oh, yeah. Is she the only lady in the prison? She is the only lady in the prison. May I tell you how many prisoners are there and how many rooms are there?
If anything happens to her, there will be problems both in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Please take that into consideration.
That's the most lame excuse I've heard.
And he is misleading. It's misleading because she is convicted for corruption. She is convicted for corruption. All citizens are equal in this country. There cannot be one set of treatment for a corrupt a neta and for someone convicted for corruption who is not a neta. All citizens are equal. You are a lawyer. I don't have to tell you. She is in jail not because of political agitation.
He says politicians get better amenities. Mr. T.K. Selangor, corruption. You are from the DNK. You are opposed to Sasikala. But your alliance partner, the Congress party in Karnataka, is giving five-star treatment to Sasikala. There is the capacity of 3,000 people, in fact, 3,000 people in Bengaluru, and there are 4,500 inmates in the Bengaluru jail. By that logic, with 1,500 more people than the jail can accommodate, can Sasikala be actually justified in getting five-room suite for herself as a prison cell? Mr. T.K. Selangovan, is that the five-star treatment that she was convicted for?
I don't approve of any special privilege to any prisoner. I don't approve of any special privilege to any prisoner. Everybody should be treated equal because that may create commotion among the other prisoners, which may lead to, we have seen in many prisons, fight among the prisoners have occurred. That apart, this family is known for bribing. That is the one question. See, even recently, TTV Dinakaran was accused of bribing the election commission. But what the BJP government did? The eight ministers were accused of paying 89 crores for the elections, for one assembly election. The election was stopped. But the CBI arrested TTV Dinakaran, but no, in the charge sheet his name was not found. In many cases in Tamil Nadu, wherever raids were held by the CBI or by the Ministry of Finance, no action was taken against any of these people. So these people can bribe, be it BJP or any other official in any other state government. They are safe.
Congress party is ruling Karnataka, not the BJP.
Yes.
Why don't you talk about the Congress party and Mr.
BJP has done what? What BJP has done to Dinakaran?
What about Congress party? Why are you diverting from this issue of Sasikala?
This family,
why are you not responding to the Congress party to Siddaramaiah?
No. I am talking about this family. I will tell you, wait. I am talking about this family. They can go to any extent. They can play with money. That is what has happened in Karnataka. That is what has happened in Delhi. That is what has happened in R.K. Nagar by-election. They are protected by BJP.
So maybe your alliance partner, the Congress party?
That's all. I don't see any difference.
So Congress is protecting her despite the fact that you are the alliance partner. Congress is protecting Sasikala.
I'll tell you. The chief minister.
But before that investigation takes place, he shuns out the DIG.
Let us wait for the report.
But before that, even before the inquiry can take place.
The fellows, BJP boys, who are violating traffic rules.
So if it happens in Uttar Pradesh, it is all right. If it happens in Karnataka,
have you joined the ADMK? I think it's
no,
so... No.
Mr. Elangovan, question coming to you from the BJP. Mr. Elangovan, have you joined the AIADMK? BJP is asking you the question.
Is there a DMK?
Are you joining the AIADMK?
Are you cousins of corruption? Are you and Sasikala, are you not cousins in corruption? I think you have, your DMK has exactly the same background.
You are not, we are
not
facing
covered
the charges.
Yourself with glory.
We are facing the charges.
You have not covered yourself
what
with glory.
What happened to D.T. Vidyanagaran?
You have done
why
the
he was arrested?
You are, your party, your party is infamous for the worst of scams in this country. So do not speak as a paragon of virtue. You
represent you tell
the
me where, what have you proved?
In the south of
all
India.
Charges false. What have you proved so far? What charges
what,
proved
what,
so far?
The whole Jalalabad scam. I think you have the temerity.
Jalalabad
scam. Scam. You was not perpetrated.
Supreme Court order.
2 lakh crores.
Supporting her.
I think Raja.
No, no. Our, the charges against her are baseless. And we are facing
what charges?
The,
whole country
we are
knows.
Not punished for
2G scam, 2G spectrum scam is your creation.
What country? Let the court
and you ran the most
the
corrupt government even
what
in
spectrum?
Tamil Nadu.
Spectrum is the most useless charge. Most useless charge manipulated by the
most
CIG
useless.
With your support.
I think you
and
don't
CIG
think 2 lakh crores is enough money for the DMK.
Our CIG is
you don't
enjoying.
Think 2 lakh crores
because
is enough money
the,
to the DMK?
BJP
you think it's a useless scam?
Many credits.
I think you are.
Let
you were
see.
In power
let,
at the center.
We are waiting
you
for
were
the
partners
judgment.
In the government at the UPA.
We were.
And,
we are
and your
Mr. Ilangovan, A. Raja went to jail for more than a year.
See,
A. Raja went to jail in the 2G spectrum scam for more than
what
a year,
I
and you are saying it's a useless
no, no.
charge.
What?
No, you are speaking like cousins in corruption.
We are waiting
in
the court. We know that it is a useless charge. Let us let the judgment come.
Should
that apart, here these
Alimuddin Khan wants to come in. Alimuddin Khan and Danish Ali want to come in. Yes, Mr. Danish Ali. Mr. Danish Ali, is the Congress Party the Congress Party guilty? Guilty of the fact that even before an inquiry can be conducted, they've shunted out the DIG who first blew the whistle on this entire issue. And today, I ask you the question, Mr. Danish Ali. Sonia Gandhi called upon all the opposition parties to answer by vote for the president's election going by their conscience. Is the conscience dead in Karnataka? Is the chief minister not liable to give any explanation to the people of this country on why he is shunting out an honest officer who blew the lid off this entire scam?
Navika, first of all, I am thankful that the Times Now has broken this story. But at the same time, we should not be selective while doing the stories. The BJP leader who is sitting here and making tall claims, may I ask what happened to Janardhan Reddy's case? May I ask why they were shut up or your channel also, other media channels also, when the women IPS officers were humiliated in Uttar Pradesh in Yogi government? What happened when in Haryana, Khattar government, Sangeeta Kalia was being humiliated by the sitting BJP?
No, but why are you not talking about IPS officers
selective.
Committing suicides in Karnataka? Have you also joined the Congress? IPS officers committing suicides in Karnataka.
We have protested.
IAS officers committing suicides in Karnataka.
We have protested.
IPS
my leader said a dharna.
We demanded a why are you acting as an apologist for Siddaramaiya? Why are you acting as an apologist for corrupt Siddaramaiya?
A CBI inquiry has taken place.
No, what? IPS officers have committed suicide.
No.
In Karnataka, IPS officers, IAS officers have been forced to commit suicide. Can you name
your cadres are doing
Gundagardi,
threatening, live on video.
You seem to be partners in this bribe. Why are you defending Siddaramaiya?
Uttar Pradesh,
when the Congress government
Haryana,
is complicit in
is there
in the
any
scam?
Difference between Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Karnataka? Both
there is
both
huge
the
difference.
Are same.
No,
are also,
in Karnataka officers are committing
suicide.
Why you are not?
You seem to be completely blind to these developments.
Where Shrestha Thakur, who was appointed DSP just 2 months back, has been shunted out from Bulandshahr because she was doing challenge of every one who was violating the rule, and some BJP worker has been challenged. She has been transferred.
Stop this rhetoric. Stop this rhetoric.
Why you are digressing from the debate? Why are you digressing from the debate, Mr. Alimuddin Khan? Mr. Alimuddin Khan. Mr. Alimuddin Khan in a jail. in a jail which has a capacity of 3,000 people, Mr. Ali Mudin Khan, there are 4,500 prisoners in the Bengaluru jail. Now, 4,500 prisoners in a place for 3,000 prisoners, and still Sasikala gets 5-room section suites that, you know, go only for her, a separate yoga room, a separate toilet, a separate kitchen, a separate visitor's room, a separate bedroom. Is she in a 5-star hotel? And that's why should people not believe DIG D. Rupa's report, which said that a 2 crore rupee bribe had been paid, Mr. Ali Mudin Khan? What's your response to that?
Navika ji, I am sure that you are well aware that for what Kiran Bedi ji got award for the jail manual maintenance. Jail manual 1978 is supposed to be revived time to time. And in Karnataka, it is in a process of revival. And this lady was supposed to attend that meeting, which she chose to opt out.
Again, you go back to the meeting.
Went to the jail.
You see. So you are saying, Mr. Satyanarayan Rao, who was the DGP prisons. You are saying that Satyanarayan Rao, who was the DGP prisons, was actually trying to emulate Ms. Kiran Bedi and try to do prison reforms only on Sasikala. Is Sasikala the only prisoner on whom prison reforms were being practiced?
You see, Navika ji, it is a discretion of the jail superintendent to give facilities as per jail manual.
Okay, so you are saying it's the discretion.
Or different category of prisoners. Okay.
So you are saying it's his discretion. So Sasikala is the discretion. And what brings about that discretion, Mr. Bijon Mishra? Mr. Bijon Mishra, what brings about the discretion? A 2 crore rupee bribe brings out the discretion of the jail superintendent?
DIG has been transferred. DIG has been transferred.
The jail superintendent gives Sasikala police reports are practiced on Sasikala and all discretion is given to Sasikala very well, and all other prisoners can rot away, they can die, but Sasikala should be given 5-star treatment. I don't know what logic is that.
My pedder is down, I believe. You don't want my word to reach to the public. You see, not only DIG.
Your fader is not down. Please don't make allegations. Do not make allegations. Your fader is not down. We are asking you the question. The problem is you don't have an answer to the question.
And to conclude the inquiry as early as possible.
Mr. Bijon Mishra, discretion. Jail reforms, all of them only for Sasikala?
Navika, we are not trying to defend BJP or Congress.
To look after the
jail manual. Please keep quiet. It's my turn.
Please keep quiet. आप हार्मोनिक लैंग्वेज यूज करेंगे, आई विल नॉट अलाउ यू.
आप 2 मिनट चुप
रहिए. नो सर,
2 मिनट चुप रहिए.
यू आर अ जेंटलमैन. डोंट अडॉप्ट लैंग्वेज ऑफ बीजेपी. डोंट अडॉप्ट लैंग्वेज ऑफ गुंडा. प्लीज लिसन द डिसेंट.
It's my turn.
Mishra ji, if you say keep quiet, no, I'm not your student.
Mr. Bijon Mishra, Mr. Ali Mudin Khan, Mr. Ali Mudin Khan, gentlemen, I'm completely out of time, but only to be fair to Mr. Bijon Mishra, last 10 seconds to Mr. Bijon Mishra. Mr. Ali Mudin Khan, you've had your turn. Please allow the common citizen, and the citizen's voice has importance on this channel, even if for the Congress party it's not important. Yes, Mr. Bijon Mishra, last 10 seconds.
Navika, we are not talking in favor of BJP or Congress. We want institutionalized activity within the jails. We don't want people like Sanjay Hegde, who are hired by the government, and he has confessed on this channel, and there's a conflict of interest, and he starts preaching us. You have to be neutral. You have to make sure that you are neutral.
Mr. Mishra,
and
you will stop misrepresenting what I say.
And the neutrality will come when you accuse yourself
Mr. Mishra, you will stop representing
so
what I say. I'm sorry, I have
don't try to preach us. So we want,
whichever way you look at it, whichever way we look at it, it is going to raise questions. DIG D. Rupa shunted out. She raised questions. She sent two reports, both reports pointing out to five-star facilities. And now those visuals and pictures don't lie, ladies and gentlemen. Those pictures on your screen show what a five-room suite has been given to Sasikala in the Bengaluru jail. And Siddaramaiah, the arrogant chief minister of Karnataka, says he doesn't owe anybody any answers. Is that an acceptable reply, viewers? The decision is all yours. Thank you very much to all my panelists for joining me here on debate number one.